So you wait till I say now you do it. White side up. I'm going to bring two opposite corners together. I'm going to hold it here with one hand, slide my fingers to the center, and go up and down. There you go. I'm going to turn this over to make sure that you remember to take it, because it sort of blends into the table. Line facing you, and it looks like a giant letter V is in Victor. I'm going to bring one side of the V up to but not over the center fold. Kind of, yep. You know, a lot of these folds are similar to each other when they start. And then I'm going to bring the other side of the V up to but not over the center line. And you're going to end up with what in this country we call an ice cream cone fold.
There you do it. If you turned it over, it would be called a kite fold. But this time, we call it an ice cream cone.
And it looks like ice cream. Here's my swan's nose, and there's the tail. I'm going to do two steps. I'm going to bring the nose all the way back to the tail. Ooh, look, my swan has a beautiful stripe. Yay. And then I'm going to bring the nose back down. How far? You decide. Depends on how long you want the neck to be or how big you want the head to be. Okay, now you do it. Yes. I was going to suggest, but I see you already know, sometimes when the paper is crinkling, if you go on the inside, but you seem to already know that. So good. You must do folding.
I can fold a small mini car with one piece of origami paper.
Oh, good for you.
That's transformer.
Oh, a transformer. Very nice. I probably can't do that. Oh, okay. Do you fold from diagrams or do you just fold from, do you know about Origami USA? Okay, because if you go on the internet, they have diagrams there. No, I can't make that either, but if you go on to this site on the internet, they have diagrams for some things. Okay, now I'm going to do a mountain fold the long way, all right, with the head on the outside, and then squeeze everything down. Go ahead, now you do it. Yeah. Sometimes I have to use more imaginative languages. Oh, I'm sorry, the shop is closing. Yeah, it's lunchtime for some of us. Okay. So now I have my swan, but my swan is sleeping. I'm going to hold the feathers and go to the back of the head, lift up the head, and spiderweb my fingers to the chest to bring the head up. Now you do it, to bring the neck up. Okay. You can do that in the air if you prefer, but for non-folders, I usually do this. And I do the same thing. I have my swan, but he's very shy, so I lift up the head, squeeze the back of the neck. Now, let us see if our swan will swim. Just open up the bottom a little bit. Oh, and fold it under. Looks good to me.